Hey guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 189. The cabinet decision on the telecom sector are a watershed moment set by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday. The PM said that the reforms are a win-win for the sector and consumers as they will ensure a sectorial growth and a job opportunities. And this will place a critical role in connecting and empowering our nation. And the cabinet has approved a PLI schema for the auto industry and drone industry. This will give an impetus to manufacturing and bring the sector at par with global trends as well as best practices. The 5G spectrum will most probably be held in Feb 2022, and the government may even try for the January timeline, Telecom Minister Ashwini Vaishnav said on Wednesday. Vaishnav said that the telecom reforms package cleared by the cabinet is adequate for the survival of existing players and will ensure robust competition in the sector, with more reforms and more structural changes that are in the pipeline. And he also said that more players should come into the market. Xiaomi 11 Lite 5G New Edition India launch date is set for September 29th. The phone made its global debut on Wednesday. Xiaomi 11 Lite 5G New Edition price in India is tipped to be under Rs 30,000. Vivo X70 Pro and X70 Pro Plus tipped to launch on September 30th in India. Vivo will skip the vanilla X70 for the Indian variant. Vivo X70 Pro and X70 Pro are rumored to be priced at Rs 49,990 and Rs 69,990. The Vivo Wireless Sport Lite is the company's second audio product in India. It is a neckband-style headphone that comes up to 18 hours of battery life. Vivo is expected to launch the Wireless Sport Lite in India on September 21st. After confirming the device existence earlier this month, Realme recently confirmed that its upcoming smartphone dubbed as Realme GT Neo 2 will be officially launched in the Chinese market on 22nd September. And the Realme has confirmed that the GT Neo 2 will be featuring a diamond ice core cooling system to control the device temperature. The Realme Q5 series will likely offer 5G connectivity at an affordable price. A TINA listing has revealed that the phone will support 65W fast charging support and get a 4400mAh battery. The 3C listing also shows a 65W fast charging adapter in the box. GoPro Hero 10 Black has just been announced, which introduces a more powerful GP2 processor for better overall performance. The new action camera comes in as a successor to the Hero 9 Black that was launched last year. GoPro Hero 10 Black promises improved video recording and UI performance, HyperSmooth 4.0 stabilization, and a higher refresh rate for the front display. The new GoPro Hero 10 Black will be available in India in early November for Rs 54,500, and GoPro Hero 10 Black will be available to purchase via Amazon, Flipkart, Chroma and selected retail stores. OnePlus 9RT has received a China's 3C certification with the model number MT2110. The listing shows the phone will have a 65W fast charging support. OnePlus 9RT specifications could include a 6.55 inch Full HD Plus display, Snapdragon 870 processor and a 50 megapixel camera. Oppo is rumored to launch Oppo F19s in India during the festive season. Oppo F19s will join F19, F19 Pro and F19 Pro Plus 5G. Oppo F19s will come with a 6.43 inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display, 48 megapixel triple rear camera and a 5000mAh battery. Google has cooked up a delicious new way to promote its upcoming Pixel 6 smartphone series. The search giant has given a 10,000 packets of Google-branded potato chips in Japan, and Google Japan launched a dedicated website to give away the packets of chip. These chips were given to the first 10,000 applicants, and Google Japan reportedly developed a marketing campaign on its own. Video shows that people using bags of chips like a smartphone. Google is expected to release the Pixel 6 in October. WhatsApp's beta program has finally reached a wide rollout across iOS and now allows all users on the latest version of WhatsApp to access the multi-device option. The new feature brings support for using one WhatsApp account across up to 4 devices, including a macOS Windows computer, a Facebook portal or a device running on WhatsApp web session. Sadly, you still cannot link a secondary phone to your main account. Facebook's messaging service WhatsApp on Wednesday launched a new feature to make it possible to search for businesses within its application for the first time. The testing has happened in Brazil, which allows WhatsApp users to find shops and services through a directory in the application. This is the latest feature in Facebook's drive to bolster e-commerce on its services. PUBG new state pre-registration has crossed around 40 million mark on iOS and Android. Krafton opened pre-registration in India on September 1st. PUBG new state launch date will be revealed in October. Honor announced a new key partnership, this time with Microsoft. A press release stated both companies will be working together to develop smart and integrated technology solutions to seamlessly enhance consumer experiences, which doesn't mean anything in particular. And Honor's Smart Life event will take place on September 26, where the Honor Magic V14 will debut with Windows 11 out of the box. The teaser reveals the laptop will have a dual 5-megapixel camera, which is going to be a first in its class. Recently, Asus has discovered an email scam where a third party is claiming to be an Asus representative. The message typically asked the affected customers to click on the embedded link to create a review in the exchange for advertising revenue. This communication is fake. Please do not click on this link and access the site or provide any information. Information security is the Asus priority. And if you believe that you have been affected by this scam, please contact the local Asus customer service center and report it to the given link in the description. Apple has announced that the iOS 15 software will be available from September 20th. iPadOS 15 and iPads will also start rolling out from September 20th. Both new software versions will bring new features and better privacy. Windows has announced that it is now possible for Microsoft account holders to sign in without a password. Instead, users can log in using a Microsoft Authenticator, Windows Hello, a security key or a verification code. This feature will be extended to the full suite of Microsoft applications. It was first introduced passwordless sign-ins for Windows 10 in 2019, where users could replace their password with Windows Hello Face, fingerprint or PIN to sign into their computers. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.